My name is Ben Brown, and I was the editor on Life and Death Row, the second episode, Judgment. The story of the film was a young man called Guy Hines Jr. was accused of killing 8 members of his own family, and the film documented his trial.
All right, for sure, please.
And had access to his family, the jury, the defence team, and partially the prosecution.
Is not anywhere in the house.
My role in essence on the film was the same as any other documentary film editing role, which is to watch all the footage and put the best bits in the best order. Pacing it, making it feel right, getting the right structure, the right emotional balance, and that's it in a nutshell.
Juror number 3, juror number 4.
Juror 32.
Juror number 8.
Juror number 11 in the Guy Hines Jr. trial.
It was very much a balance between the audience's relation to their subjects and the more dry process of the evidence of the trial.
There are certain things that you hear that you go, oh wow, okay, good, there's no way he could have done this. And then, you know, it could be as early as 5 minutes later, you know, when the rebuttal comes up, you go, oh man, okay, well that poked a hole in front, in that whole theory.
We tried to let the audience go on a journey of discovering the truth about whether or not he did it and how they felt about it.
This defendant beat members of his family to death with the barrel end of a shotgun.
In terms of the relationship with the PD, with John Douglas, sharing creative or editorial control, he gave me a lot of space to have my own insights and impact on cutting it together. Organising and managing the material, I personally write down everything that I see. For this film, for example, we watched, I think, for at least 3 weeks before I made a single cut. And in those 3 weeks, I probably filled about 6 A4 notebooks full of my scribbling to do with every aspect of the trial. If you sit and watch day after day of material, you forget your first reaction, and your first reaction is all that matters. And actually, when I go to cut the film, I'm really not going back to the rushes at all. I'm going back to my notebooks, which is a sort of summary of those rushes, and particularly, I'm going back to my comments on those rushes, the ticks, the stars, the quite simple illustrations that I've put next to them to sort of remind me of how I felt about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's it for the day.
We'll see you at 8:15 in the morning.
Making a film without commentary isn't actually as taxing as it might seem. As long as you've got the right interviews, the right access, you're just trying to tell a story. And if you can do that through interview, or sometimes even without interview, audiences are extremely perceptive. If you've got a strong story, you don't need to often cover it in voiceover.
Are you able to cut the 6:30 package for 6?
Occasionally throughout the film, we used reporters outside or the radio archive from the time of the trial. Often just to headline one thing. So if the section that was coming up in the film was to do with the motive or whatever specific part of the film, we would just use a part of that broadcast that just focused the minds of the audience as to what they were about to see.
We want the case concluded, obviously want a guilty verdict, but juries make that decision and we deal with it.
Film without commentary, you're constructing it sometimes out of the tiniest words, one moment in the one part of one day, and you're constructing it so the audience know, aha, this is about the motive, or this is about whatever part of the trial that it was.
I didn't see it coming.
You never know what the jury's gonna do, right?
Unbelievable.
Trying to decide what to keep in the film and what to omit. Once we have a rough cut, we review that. Our emotional responses to that scene or those scenes will lead us to probably including it. Sometimes, though, not, you know, something can be strong and emotional, but it's not going to make it because it's too similar or it leans too much one way, trying to keep the film balanced. And there were other scenes in the trial itself where people were crying or, you know, it was quite strong, but it wasn't part of evidence or an area of the film that we were concentrating on. So it wouldn't make it. My advice to any editor on any form of documentary is to get enough space for yourself, create enough space for yourself, watch it all, try not to get pushed off course during the processes that naturally happen when putting something on television at prime time, and go with your gut and hold your nerve.